Hi, you guys, Mrs. Valdivia. So we're going to be doing empirical formulas, a little quick pre-lab for us. Empirical formulas is basically the smallest formula possible for a bond that forms, right? So example, if we had like magnesium, or if we had, let's say, a metal and a non-metal combined together, some sort of ionic compound, right? Then we want to create empirical formulas. So one of the most common empirical formulas that we've seen is H2O. That is two hydrogens to one oxygen, right? This is the lowest ratio possible. What if you saw this, H4O2? Is this an empirical formula? No, this would not be the empirical formula because this is at a higher ratio value. So we learned this back in like chapter one and three, I believe, as well, where we're talking about the lowest ratios possible, okay? So we want the lowest ratio. H2O in this case cannot get any lower than that. Sometimes though, when we do our experimental values, these ratios end up reporting much higher, right? So we end up with ratios similar to this one. And we have to be able to divide it by the smallest ratio possible. So here, I'm gonna rewrite it. And we will divide it by the smallest ratio possible in order to figure out, well, what is that ratio going to be? So we get H2O. Okay. All right, let's go ahead and go through our lab and see what we need to figure out. So we're going to be doing this experiment virtually. Okay. Now, before we start our lab, let's just look at the purpose. It's to determine the empirical formulas of magnesium chloride by reacting magnesium with hydrochloric acid. So we're reacting magnesium with hydrochloric acid, okay? So here, let's do this. We're gonna have magnesium solid reacting with hydrochloric acid, right? And that's aqueous. So this is a single replacement reaction that's gonna occur, and we're gonna end up with magnesium chloride plus hydrogen. And we know that hydrogen's diatomic, so it's H2 and it's his gas. And then we have to balance out our magnesium chloride. And we know magnesium makes a +2 and chlorine makes a -1. If we crisscross those charges, you're gonna end up with magnesium chloride, and it's 1:2 ratio. And this is gonna be our goal throughout the lab, is to end up with this ratio based on our data. Okay, but how exactly are we going to do that? There is a couple of steps that we need to do in order to find out what your ratios are actually going to be, like your mole ratios. So to determine mole ratios, or reduced mole ratios, you need the following. One, if you have grams, so obtain grams, right? So let's say we've obtained the grams. And after we obtain the number of grams, we want to convert grams into moles. And how do we convert grams into moles? We use the molar mass. And where do we obtain the molar mass? From the periodic table. And I know you guys already know that, but it's always good to repeat it because then it goes like easy in our head. So after we get this, we get the number of moles for each of the substance that we're looking for. And in this case, our lab flow told us that we're looking for magnesium chloride. We want the ratio for magnesium chloride. Okay. So we have two items, so you're going to do it for both, right? Now that you have the moles of each, you're going to divide the mole values by the smallest value. So what does that mean? That means that if you have mole A and you have mole B, but mole A is greater than mole B, so this is the bigger number, right? You did your molding, you're like, oh wow, mole is the bigger number. Then you're gonna have this. You're gonna have mole of A divided by mole of B, and you're gonna have mole of B divided by mole of B. Okay, so these are gonna be your two problems. Now you already know that one of these is gonna equal the number one. The other one, we don't know what that's gonna equal. It could be a whole number, or it could be a ratio. So let's just pretend this is going to give us a ratio, and that ratio is like 1.3 or 1.4, whichever one of these numbers it's going to be, right? We know that it's not an equal ratio, so something's up with this, right? We have to do something. Are we going to round down? Are we going to round up? What do we have to multiply this by in order to get a proper answer? Now, when we're doing our lab actually has a section where it tells you, like, what can you multiply it by in order to obtain a better number? And that's actually in our report here. Okay. So, we have to do some sections first in order to figure that out. But you're going to end up multiplying it by a number. And you don't actually need those numbers that is on the chart. You could just figure it out. What you're trying to do is multiply it by something to get a whole number. So you're going to take your 1.3 and maybe you have to multiply it by 4. Or maybe you have to multiply it by 3. Whatever is going to give you a whole number is what you're looking for, right? So if I were to multiply that by 3, I get a 3.9, which is basically a 4. So I would get a 4. And then this one would be a 3, I believe. Okay, so you have a 4-3 kind of ratio. All right, but we're not going to worry about this one yet here. Okay, all I know is that I have more of this and less of this, right? More of this, less of that. Okay, let's go ahead and do the lab, and then we're going to see where this actually plays a part to figuring out what our mole ratio is going to be. Because our goal now, we have magnesium X and chlorine Y, is what are these going to be? First of all, I don't know which one's X and I don't know which one's Y. I just wrote A and B randomly. So we want to know what they're going to be. And when we do our lab, you're going to have decimals, okay? Because we're going to be working with experimental grams. So we're going to have decimals, and then we're going to play the multiplication kind of multiplication trial and error to get the whole number from it, which we kind of know what it's going to be. All right, so let's go ahead and look at this. Okay. So the first section is going to be our watch plate, our evaporating dish right here. And we want to know how much it weighs, right? So right here is an evaporating dish. Right here is a watch plate. And the reason why they're measuring both is because you're going to heat up this watch plate. So now we're going to add our ribbon. As you can see, it's a full little piece of nice magnesium ribbon. We haven't done anything to this ribbon yet. So I like to take data, and I'm going to take my data right here. I know now that I have 63.018 is the grams of the entire thing here. And I'm going to subtract that from this number here, 62.798 grams. And I'm going to obtain the mass of my magnesium ribbon. All right, so I've obtained the mass of my magnesium ribbon. Okay, let's see what's next. All right, now we're gonna actually go through the procedure. So what we're gonna do, I said burned earlier, we're actually going to be creating a chemical reaction with the hydrochloric acid. So we're dropping hydrochloric acid inside of the magnesium, and it's gonna be reacting in a single replacement reaction, okay? And it's gonna react in this tray, and we're gonna end up with this white powdery substance. That white powdery substance is our magnesium chloride. The hydrogen actually, since it's a gas, it evaporated out into the air. So we have a mass now, and this is the magnesium chloride plus everything else. So let's write that down. All right, now I'm going to proceed. My data is done. I can't change none of my data. Okay, question time. Complete the following calculations. Okay, here's the masses. Calculate the mass of magnesium. Oh, I already did that. So we calculate the mass of magnesium by taking these numbers and subtracting them from each other. Okay, that's the mass of my magnesium. Now it says, calculate the mass of the product. So what was our product? At the end of the reaction, we ended up with the mass of the product. So what we want to do is we want to take this number minus this number right here. So minus the mass of the magnesium ribbon one. So that was 63.018 grams. Okay. And once I take those, I got it. All right. Now it wants me to calculate the mass of chlorine on its own. So that's quite simple. This is the mass of magnesium. This is the mass of magnesium chloride. Just gonna subtract both of them together in order to get my answer. Now, I'm gonna actually round this because I believe it wants it in two significant digits. So I'm gonna round that. Okay. So now I'm gonna take my answer here and I'm gonna go ahead and put 0.66 minus 0.22. And I get 0.44. All right, there we go. Mole calculations. Now it wants us to calculate the number of moles. And we said that we're going to do that by converting grams into moles. So we want the moles of magnesium products. So let's actually, I'm going to leave that there. And I'm going to put up my screen here. Okay. So in order to calculate the moles of my magnesium product, that's this one right here, I'm going to take my 0.22 grams of magnesium, and I am going to divide it by the molar mass of magnesium. And the molar mass of magnesium, well, we're going to look at a periodic table right here. We're going to find magnesium, and it's 24.3. All right, 24.3 is the moles of magnesium. So 24.3 is the mole of my magnesium. So I'm going to take my 0.22 divided by 24.3. And I get 9.05 times 10 to the negative 3. Now, LabFlow isn't going to accept my answer like this. So I'm just going to convert it. And that's going to be, okay. And this is the number of moles of magnesium. Now, I believe it's going to ask me the same moles of chlorine. So we're going to do the same. I'm going to take my number that I found for chlorine. And I am going to do the molar mass conversion. I'm going to look for chlorine on the periodic table. And chlorine is 35.45. Grams cancel out. Grams cancel out. So I have 0.655 divided by 35.45, and I end up with 0.018. Okay. Now that I have my numbers, I'm going to go back here, and I'm going to start plugging them in. So for 0.0091, and for this one, I got 0.018. Right, now it's when the questions are popping off, right? So let's look at the questions that are coming out. Okay. It says, report the mole ratio as a single number, not two numbers separated by a column, but as a single number. So the mole ratio that we got, we have, I don't know why I did that. All right, I skipped this part. Determine the empirical formula based on your data, which element has the smallest number of moles. If we look at both of these, we could see that magnesium has the smallest number of moles. Now that we did that, it wants us to report the mole ratio to the smallest number. And we're going to do that by dividing by the smallest mole. So we're going to divide each by smallest moles, right? So that's kind of, where did I show you guys that? Showed you guys somewhere. So we're going to take it and divide by the smallest mole possible on both of them. Just close this so I don't get confused. So this one is 0.0091, so I'm just going to take it and divide it by 0.0091, and I'm going to take this and divide it by 0.0091. This is going to give me 1, and I don't know what that's going to give me, so divide it by 0.0091. And this one gave me a 2.03. So I ended up with a 1-to-2 ratio possible. Okay, so my ratio here, I'm gonna say I have magnesium 1 and chlorine had a 2 on it. It wants two significant figures, so I ended up with a 1.0, and then I ended up with a 2.0 actually, so 2 decimal places. It's not taking it. Let's see, or is it? Maybe. Oh, we'll see. We'll see if it takes it or not. All right. Okay. So now we're going to look down here. It says initial subscripts from mole ratio. My initial subscript was 1.0. My initial subscript right here was actually 2.0, which I ended up pretty lucky with my data here. It says if you ended up with the decimal that's like less than 0.1, which we did round down. We rounded down to 2.0. If you end up with a decimal that's like 0.2, multiply that decimal by 5. If you end up with a decimal that's 0.25, multiply it by 4. Multiply the decimal by that number, the decimal, okay? And see what that gives you, and it should work just fine. Now it says, and if you end up with numbers that are like really high, suddenly you're like, oh my gosh, I have a 4 here and a 2 here. Well, just divide it by each other. Remember, you're looking for the lowest ratio possible. All right. Using the table as a guide, select how you will round or multiply your initial subscripts. Actually, my mole ratio is already in whole numbers, so I don't have to do that. Finalizing empirical formula, determine the whole number subscripts in the formula. So my whole number here is 1, and my whole number for this one was a 2. Right? And then here I would explain and see if my answer makes sense. Yes, my answer makes sense because the magnesium has a +2 charge and chlorine has a -1 charge. Therefore, I need 2 chlorines, and chlorine has a -1 charge. So I need 2 chlorines for every 1 magnesium, and that would give me MgCl2 as my final answer. And I would actually write down the explanation right there. So, okay, I hope this video helps you guys out and that you guys are able to easily do this and find out what your empirical formula is. All right, take care, you guys. Ciao.